T.N. Hari, Head of HR at BigBasket. I also am an advisor at the Fundamentum Partnership, which is a homegrown VC fund set up by Nandan Nilekani and Sanjeev Agarwal. I also am a sounding board to numerous young founders and startups. So talent strategies will have to depend on the stage of growth. Specifically, for example, at an early stage company, there will be a lot of hustle to do, and multiple roles will be played by the same person. And you need to ensure that you manage your costs well. You can't bring in heavy hitters who don't have a full-time role to play. But once your product market fit gets established and you're ready to scale, that's when you need to bring in people who understand how to scale without the wheels coming off. So that's when you need to bring in a different category of people, people who can do some kind of big game hunting, do the heavy lifting, and people who've seen scale before. So basically, the kind of people that you hire would depend on the stage of growth. But it also depends upon, you know, the culture of the company and the business context. So two similar organizations, both of which having acquired a product market fit, large companies or reasonably large scale companies, can still have different approaches to talent based on their cultural context and their business context. So today at the NASSCOM Summit, I was speaking of two specific examples, BigBasket and Daksh. Both had reached a stage where they had grown rapidly, but their approaches to talent was very different because the business context were very different. And Daksh was a very profitable company, and BigBasket was a company that was struggling to break even, which was a low margin business. So we were trying to scale, manage costs frugally, and therefore this reflected in our approach to talent, where we hired people who could punch above their weight class. We hired people at the right time. We never got them ahead of time because those costs would then have been very high or prohibitive to carry. Whereas at Daksh, we took those risks. We brought in heavy hitters. We brought in people, you know, who were ready to, you know, scale and take the company to the next level. People who could execute well, think very clearly, and communicate well. We got these people ahead of time, even before business came to us. And it was not just in talent, it applied to facilities as well. Whereas at a place like BigBasket, we just wanted people who could execute well. Even if they could think, you know, reasonably clearly but not perfectly, that was okay with us because somebody else would do the thinking for them. As long as they could execute well, it was good enough for us. And communication skills just didn't matter at all. So basically, the point I'm trying to make is that your approach to talent, acquiring and retaining talent, really depends upon your business context and your culture. If you don't understand these two well, you will never be able to do the right things when it comes to talent.